Hello friends, once again in the next lecture of the UI scroll view. So friend, today lecture we will discuss about how we can use scroll view with the help of the constraint. So friend, in my previous lecture I have already discussed what is UI static scroll view, how we can use it. So first lecture is the topic of static scroll view. So friend, I have already created the lecture on the static scroll view and dynamic scroll view. So in the part 1 and part 2 I have already covered the two topics. So friend, if you did not watch my previous two lectures of the scroll view, I have given the link in the description box, so you can check in the description box. So friend, today is our topic is how we can use scroll view with constraint. So friend, in the same way again we will add the another UI view controller and embed this UI view controller with tab bar. So we will add another tab for constant scroll view. So here we will add, click on the view controller. So here another tab is already added. So friend, here we add the two tabs for the dynamic scroll view and another tab for the constant scroll view. So friend, I have already created the lecture of the tab view. If you did not my lecture of the tab view, I have also given the link in description box. So in detail we will not discuss about how we add the tab view. So here is the third tab view for the scroll view, constant scroll view. So here we can change the name, scrolling scroll view with constant. So here is the topic, scroll view with constant. And again in the same way like in the previous lectures, we will add the UI scroll view on the storyboard. Click on the scroll view and here we will add, and here we add the constraints and click on the content layer guides. We'll uncheck it. So here the error is removed. So friend, here again we will add a UI view on the UI scroll view. Like in my previous lectures, I have already added UI view on the scroll view. So here we will also add the UI view on the scroll view and add the constant. So here 0 0 and here 0. So all the four constant we will add here, and add here the height of the UI view equal to UI scroll view. So here equal to 1. So here we will take the equal height equal to UI view equal heights, and here we set the priority. So we will edit the low priority here. So now it's the content view of the scroll view. So now it's content view. We can change it the name here, content view, and here we will add the content on the view. So add on the library. And here we click on the images. Suppose I will add the images. So here we will add the fix height 200. And now copy and paste it. So add the constraint of the UI label 0 and here suppose 10 space in the bottom side. Zero and here the height will remove it. Here we remove the height of the Now we will add the label height. So in here we add aspect ratio of the image. And here the another important point here is, suppose we want to change the dynamic height of the label. In this way, here is the fixed image and here is the aspect ratio image, and the content in between this, it can be any label, it can be two label and three label like this. But here we will taking the example of the one label. Suppose here is the one label and we want change the height of the, this label. So in this case we will change edit here. So in this case we click on the edit and here we will change the priority and set it to greater than. So its height, now the label height can be greater than and equal to 20.30. So here we will add the images. Suppose in my previous lecture I have added the images is here. Suppose is the name of the images imgbeauty1, imgbeauty2, like we have added in previous lecture. So we will add here imgbeauty1 and here content mode we will change into aspect fill. And in the same way in the second image imgbeauty2 and here content mode aspect fill. Yeah, so now is the class of this UI view controller. So we will take, so here the class we will add. So UI view controller is already added in our project. So we will take it and suppose we will add the outlet of UI label. So click on the editor and here click on the UI view controller. Here is the label and so here we can take any name, suppose LBL message. So here we will add the outlet of the UI label and we will close it. So now I am running the project. So here we run it again. So it's our previous tab static scroll view and click on the scroll view with constraint. The third tab, so here we can check the scrolling is not working because our content size is less than scroll view size. So here we can check our scrolling is not working because our content size height is less than the scroll view height. So suppose, so here we have already added the outlet of label. So click on the UI view controller and suppose here we will add the content. After it we will check the scrolling. LBL message, I will type here dot text. We'll use the text property of the label and here in typing here like this, any dummy text we will type here. So so we here copy it and again paste it like this. So here is the content of the label. So now we run it again and check the scrolling. So click on the scroll with constraint and here we can check the scrolling is not working again. So what is the reason for it? So we check it. So I think something is wrong because here scrolling is not working and the data is showing. So here the label text is the big data here, but the data is showing only in the single line. So I think the size of the label is not expanding, because I think we check the property of the label here, lines. So here we change the line of the label is 0 whenever we want to expand the label size. So the line should be equal to 0, and now again we run it. So here click on the scroll with constraint. Yeah, so here we can check the scrolling is working, because size of the label is expanding according to the text size. So like this we can add the scroll view with the help of the constraint, and with the help of the content we can set the size of the scroll. Thanks for the watching. So friend, if you like this video, please like, share and subscribe the channel.